How's your leg?
It hurts a little.
And your stomach?
Empty as a football.
And your love life?
Not too active.
Anything else bothering you?
Mm-hmm. Who are you?
Reading from top to bottom. Lisa. Carol. Fremont.
I would say that the mystic is probably the most underrepresented in popular culture and also the most misunderstood, but actually quite present. I realize that even though you don't see the mystic a lot in popular culture and it's this energy so misunderstood, it's actually quite present in terms of the percentage of, at least the percentage of women that take the quiz on my site. There are quite a few women that identify very strongly with mystic energy. So the mystic really represents the independent, creative, introverted woman who prioritizes more than anything her inner peace, her tranquility, higher levels of consciousness. It's that energy where you don't really need to be interacting with the rest of the world. You can find your fulfillment through the spirit. If you've ever been in a home with like a warm fire blazing and there's just this feeling of it's cold outside and you're sitting by the fire and you just feel relaxed and you feel comfortable and you feel at peace and you feel tranquil, that feeling, it's hard to describe, but that's basically what the mystic feeling is. Like she's embodied by the hearth. Like she represents the warmth at the core of a home, the warmth at the core of a family, the warmth at the core of society. Oftentimes these women, yes, they're introverted, but they often are soulful. There's something soulful about them. There's something serene about them. There's something tranquil about them. And there's something warm and magnetic about them. So if we look at Sade, if you look at Nicole Kidman, Greta Garbo, Frida Kahlo, these are famous mystic women. What really enticed us about them the most was the fact that they was their introversion, the fact that we couldn't get quite good enough of them. Frida Kahlo, her artwork actually often reflected her introversion. Sade, as a musical artist, you know, if you listen to her voice, it is calm. It's like a fire.
This may come.
It's like a fire blazing. It's calm, it's serene, but people love it. And she's got this sort of magnetic, soulful, tranquil, serene presence. And she literally comes out with an album like once a decade and yet stays on the airwaves and stays relevant. We are enamored by the distance just as much as we're enamored by the serenity and the tranquility and the soulfulness of her. Grace Kelly retreated from Hollywood, from Monaco, after she became princess. But even today, we remember her serene, dignified nature. Greta Garbo's mystery is what made her an enduring screen siren. Nicole Kidman is a little bit more extroverted. She would be a goddess, which would be a dominant lover, secondary mystic. But even Nicole Kidman, it's not just her beauty that enamors us, but is a sense of sort of tranquility, this sort of a dream come to life persona. The mystic in terms of seduction really inspires men to dream. There's something about her that is ethereal, something about her that is just beyond a human, you know what I mean? Like if human is to be flawed, there's something about her that's kind of dignified and something very serene. Oftentimes, mystic women will have to work to understand their unique energy and their unique lifestyle needs because it's so misunderstood and kind of underrepresented in popular culture. Oftentimes, they may have to develop assertiveness and they may have to learn to work with their lover energy, which can sometimes be at odds with the mystic energy. The reason why we cultivate the mystic, and all women need to cultivate the mystic, just like the other six archetypes, is to get grounded, to learn how to live in the present, to achieve some sort of emotional distance. You know, emotional distance, I keep talking about that, but emotional distance is what allows you to think clearly when you're angry, is what allows you to think clearly when you're overwhelmed, when you are really, really happy even, or really sad, or when you're in love, you know, more than anything, when you're enamored with somebody, it allows you to kind of take yourself out of the emotion and still be able to make really good decisions, you know, even when you're overcome with the emotion. So the mystic is something that helps with emotional distance. the mystic helps you maintain your identity, your sense of inner peace, and it helps you kind of part from things that jeopardize and compromise your sense of inner peace and tranquility. It helps you overcome issues with needing validation, needing attention. It helps you overcome codependency issues that may come along with some of the other archetypes like the queen, the mother, and the maiden. It helps you overcome impulsiveness, but more than anything, the mystic really helps you develop that seductive distance that all successful, you know, seductive relationships really need. So that the interplay of intimacy mixed with a little distance just to increase that aspect of desire. And that's kind of how the mystic can help all women.